We used a simulation model to explore economic feasibility of RAS for Atlantic salmon. And so this work included a sensitivity analysis, and we found that two major factors that are influencing profitability of RAS are market price and mortality rate of the salmon. And so this is really interesting finding, and it led us to finding a need for consumer preference research and exploring willingness to pay for RAS-produced salmon. We'll be looking at different elements of the salmon, so different attributes and how consumers react to different kinds of information. And right now is really a great time to be doing this research as we're anticipating large quantities of salmon entering the market in the US. There's really a need to do some economic research related to this product. It's easy to think about salmon as like one thing, but it's actually a bundle of attributes. So there's a lot of information that consumers are reacting to when they're thinking about making a purchasing decision. So encapsulating that by engaging with different industry stakeholders is the way that we feel that we're going to be able to create a survey that really gets to what are like the highest priority questions that the industry might have as we're looking forward to marketing salmon. Willingness to pay is something, you know, as economists that we're really interested in, and we're going to be using an experiment to get at that. And so thinking about the bundle of attributes, it might be the production method. There's not really an existing literature, especially in the US market, for how consumers might prefer different kinds of farming or different information about how a fish was raised. So that's an attribute that we would really be excited to explore is, you know, what are the preferences for different kinds of farming? Other preferences that might be kind of interesting to look at for RAS specifically would be the feed. So there's so much conversation going on right now with what kinds of feed should be fed to salmon. And so, you know, part of that conversation might be on the industry side as they're making decisions related to their, you know, operating expenses and what they want to purchase to feed their fish. But at the end of the day, it also goes into potential marketing that actually could also affect willingness to pay by the consumers. We're really excited to produce actionable content for industry. So we hope that this research that's being done through this consumer preference survey will produce information that can be included in marketing plans for industry. Something that's really special about getting to do this work is that as academics, you know, we're kind of thinking about, well, these are really interesting questions, but through the engagement that we have with the SAS Squared network, we're actually able to make sure that this is what industry wants to know, and these are their priority questions. So it's really exciting to be a part of this network.